you don't want to put him on base either with a walk.
3-2 pitch. Rolled off the left field for a base hit. And so he continues.
Yes, he does.
Wow, look at him go for second. Here's the throw. And, wow, he slides in. Good hustle that time by Carp. So he's 2-for-2.
Well, he caught everybody by surprise. He thought that he saw these people being just a little nonchalant and thinking that maybe he could surprise them. Well, it sure did surprise everybody. Surprised the left fielder for sure. And then, obviously, the second baseman was distracted there at second base and let the ball get away from him.
So he's got back-to-back doubles. Here's Chris DeClerico, who's got the RBI. Plays down the bunts. And wow. They're going to have runners on the corners. Another bunt single. We've seen so many of those here.
Yes, you have. And, you know, the fact that the grass keeps the ball pretty much fair, as long as you can square it up, you know, on the bunt for hit, it's going to stay true. It's not going to roll foul. The only time that you have a rollover on the bunt or a little angle on the bat, not square, then it will go foul. But most of these balls have been staying true to form, right where they were hit. And they saw how much success Nebraska had with that from the outset of this tournament. And I know every one of those teams saw that. And so every team, I think now in the tournament, has used that to its advantage.
Here's Cameron Kane now with runners on first and third. A healthy 429 in the regionals. 13 total bases led the team. He walked back in the first inning. There's a swing and a miss, and the count goes to 1-1. He's been swinging a good stick as well, as we mentioned, a 2-for-3 with an RBI in both games, 2-for-3 with two ribbies and runs scored in the last game for New Jersey. There's a strike. It's 1-2.
New Jersey looking to add on right here.
That's under that one.
Wow.
Shortstop Riley Way just moves in a couple of feet, and there's one down. Runners stay put.
Well, that hurts. At least if you're a Hopewell Valley New Jersey team, that certainly hurts.
That's going to be up to Luke Blair. Blair flew out to the center fielder, Alex Leitz, in his only at-bat. 1-for-4 in the last game. 0-for-4 with a walk and an RBI in game number one, but coming off of a 7-RBI regional, where he actually went deep a couple of times. 2 home runs in the regionals for this young man. Michael Coryell, the head coach, calls this guy Mr. Clutch. He has come through with several big hits in clutch situations this summer.
Mm-hmm. A senior to be at the Bennington School. Good ball player.
Well, anytime you hit .620 with men on base, that's a pretty good ball player. Now he has a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. With one down here in the top of the third. Here's the 0-2 pitch. This misses for a ball. It's 1-2. Luke Blair.
Good job by the catcher, Chase Atkinson, blocking that ball.
Chin music there. It's 2-2 with one out. Coach Coryell has known this young man since he was 12 years old, as a matter of fact.
Well, wouldn't be too hard to see the signals and what they're calling and where. But the pitcher's not been able to hit the signals in the spot where he wants it. And the catcher's not mixing that up very well. We at home can see what pitch is coming. Yep, it's a fastball. Looking to be down the middle, he hopes.
And there's a shot. 620 with runners in scoring position. He backs that up with a RBI single to right field, and we've got a 2-1 ball game.
Nice piece of hitting on that part of the hitter there. I mean, he squared it up pretty well. Yes, he did. Nice sharp single into right field.
You mentioned the Pennington School. Here's another senior to be at the Pennington School. Now Nick Samaras, the third baseman. He's got a guy out
New
there.
Jersey. Yeah, they're looking to add on more. And by the way, we got a break here just for a second. We mentioned Allie Coriel at first base, the daughter of Michael Coriel. And she had a great grandfather by the name of Marius Bonacci.